To demonstrate ASP.NET, I'll be using Visual Studio. As usual, you can use any IDE or even Notepad to develop, but for this tutorial, I'll use Visual Studio throughout, since it's the standard program for ASP.NET development. First, we'll go ahead and launch the website wizard. Select the ASP.NET website template and the C# language. We'll be using C# because it's a fairly easy language to understand, even if you haven't used it before. Type the file path you want for the website and hit OK. The wizard will now create a simple website for you, consisting of the file default.aspx and its code file default.aspx.cs. ASPX is the file extension used for ASP.NET files, and the code file has the CS extension because it's a C# file. Let's look at the ASPX file first. As we can see, it's a fairly normal XHTML file with two exceptions. First, we have the ASP tag at the top of the page that specifies the language we'll use, as well as the code file. Secondly, we have the special runAtServer attributes. This attribute says that the element contains code that must be run on the server before the page is sent to the client.